Let's practice some syntheses involved with epoxides. What sequence of reagents would we use to accomplish this reaction? It may look complicated, but if you distill it down to its essence, it's actually not too bad. We're starting out with an alkyl halide, and we're ending up with a compound that has that same R group, 1,2, from an alcohol. Clearly, we're going to use a Grignard synthesis, and our electrophile will be an epoxide. Specifically, it'll be 2-methyl oxirane. Let's go through the steps. First, we need to form a Grignard reagent, and we'll use magnesium in diethyl ether to do that using the alkyl halide as our substrate. So phenyl bromide reacts with the magnesium to make phenyl magnesium bromide. So that phenyl magnesium bromide is our Grignard reagent. And next, we're going to react it with 2-methyl oxirane. The Grignard attacks the less substituted carbon, opening the ring of the epoxide and yielding an alkoxide. Let's point out that this bond came from this pair of electrons. And how do we get from our alkoxide to our alcohol? We need a source of protons. Hydronium or even a weak acid like water should do the trick. So our final step is proton transfer. And our overall synthesis looks like this. 1. Magnesium and diethyl ether. This forms our Grignard reagent. 2. The Grignard reaction, where we introduce the electrophile. In this case, the electrophile is 2-methyl oxirane. Step 3, we protonate the alkoxide. Let's do an exercise. We have 2-bromobutane, and we're trying to make 4-methyl-2-hexanol. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes, 4-methyl-2-hexanol. Don't be intimidated. I know it looks complicated, but what if you think in terms of what we've been doing? This is an R group that is 1,2 from our alcohol. Moreover, that secbutyl R group is right here. So we have an alkyl halide, and we're adding an R group, 1,2 from an alcohol. That's right. This is a Grignard synthesis with an epoxide, specifically 2-methyl oxirane. So how do we make this happen? First, we make the Grignard reagent. And to make that Grignard reagent, we react our alkyl halide, 2-bromobutane, with magnesium and diethyl ether. So there's our Grignard, secbutyl magnesium bromide. We then react it with our 2-methyl oxirane, We get nucleophilic attack in the less substituted ring carbon, opening the ring to give us an alkoxide. And this sigma bond came from this pair of electrons. Our final step, we need to protonate. Here's another exercise to try. How would we go from bromopropane to 4-octanone? Pause and work the steps. We can make the Grignard reagent using magnesium and diethyl ether. So now we have ethyl magnesium bromide. We're going to react it with an epoxide that has the right number of carbons. Specifically, a propyl group. So our nucleophilic attack happens here, and the ring opens. So now we have our alkoxide. We need to protonate it. So now we've got our alcohol. How do we get from our alcohol to our ketone? Well, we just need to do an oxidation. I would use SWERN, dimethyl sulfoxide, and oxalyl chloride. You could also use PCC, or DMP, or Jones reagent. Here's another exercise, but now we're going forward. To solve it, just go through step by step. So pause your video and work it step by step. When you're done, unpause and check your answer. Step number one, radical bromination. This selects for the more substituted alkyl bromide, in this case, 2-bromopropane. Step two, sodium ethoxide. This is going to do an elimination reaction, and we'll get propene. Zaitsev-Hoffmann is not an issue here. There's only one way to go. Step three, we make the halohydrin by reacting with Br2 in water. The OH group adds Markovnikov and the Br adds anti-Markovnikov. Step number four, sodium hydride. The hydride ion takes a proton from the alcohol, making the alkoxide and setting us up for intramolecular proton transfer, or rather intramolecular Williamson synthesis. So the alkoxide that's created by the hydride does SN2 attack at the alpha carbon where the bromine is, and now we've got 2-methyloxyrane. Step 5. Phenyl magnesium bromide. This would just be listed as PHMGBr. We're going to do nucleophilic attack on the less substituted carbon. This bond was made from this lone pair. Now we've got an alkoxide. We protonate it with water. Hydronium would work too. Now we have an alcohol. Step 7, we use pyridinium chlorochromate. And we have a ketone. Just for the record, PCC contains chromium 6. Better to use the Swern oxidation. DMSO and C2O2Cl2.